This video will show the basic use of the Model 26-1 Frisker. The Model 26-1 is an ergonomic, lightweight instrument which can be used for alpha-beta contamination monitoring or for measuring gamma exposure or dose rate. It utilizes a standard pancake Geiger-Mueller or GM detector that's capable of detecting alpha, beta, or gamma radiation. The instrument's powered by two AA batteries. To change the batteries, grab the ring on the screw. Turn the ring 1/4 turn counterclockwise. Release and remove the battery cover. Replace the two AA batteries. Replace the cover and turn the ring 1/4 turn clockwise to secure. Caution, be sure the barb on the cover is inserted correctly into the body of the 26-1 or it may break off. The Model 26 has three operational buttons on the front of the instrument. The first button is the OK button. The OK button has multiple uses. It's used to power the instrument on and off, silence the click audio, reset the max mode, start or reset the count timer, and to acknowledge audio alarms. The second unit is the U button. This is used to change the units displayed on the digital readout. The factory defaults are CPM and MR per hour. The third button is labeled M and is used to cycle between the three operating modes. The first mode is rate meter. The second mode is the max mode. The third mode is the count mode. More on these later. This part of the video has been slowed down to show the sequence of events. Turn the instrument on by pressing the OK button. The instrument should activate all of the LCD segments and the audio. If any of the LCD segments are missing, or the alarm LED fails to illuminate, or the audio fails to work, the device is in need of repair. The instrument will then move to normal operation, showing the rate meter display. Here it is in real time. After startup, check to see if the low battery icon is displayed in the lower left-hand corner of the digital display. If it is displayed, then the batteries have approximately 16 hours or less left and should be replaced. If the instrument detects a battery voltage that's high enough to power the instrument on but too low to safely operate, the display will go blank and the low battery icon will flash. Normal operation will not be available until the batteries have been replaced. The primary display mode is the rate meter and the current count rate will be displayed. Pressing the units button will switch the displayed value between the primary and secondary units. Under a non-alarm condition, pressing the OK button will turn the click audio on and off. If an alarm condition is present, pressing the OK button will acknowledge the alarm and turn off the audio. The alarm display indicator will remain on and the alarm status LED will be flashing. Pressing the mode button will change to the max mode. The word max will be displayed. And while in max mode, the highest detected count rate since the last reset is displayed. Pressing the units button will switch the displayed value between primary and secondary units. A press of the OK button will silence the click audio. Pressing it a second time will reset the display and re-enable the click audio. If an alarm condition is present, pressing the OK button will silence the audio. Pressing it again will reset the alarm and re-enable the audio. Press the mode button until you enter the count mode. When you enter the count mode, the currently selected units will display for about 1 second. Pressing the OK button will initiate the count. At the end of the count time, the results will be displayed.
That concludes the basic use and operation of the Model 26-1 Frisker. Before we go, we want to mention some optional items for the Model 26-1. One option is a device called a dose filter. This replaces the normal protective cap that comes with the instrument. When it's snapped in place on top of the detector screen, it acts as an energy compensation filter. Like many types of detectors, the pancake tube overresponds to low-energy gamma radiation. You can see the overresponse as the red line on the graph. When the dose filter is used, the response is much more accurate to low-energy gamma radiation, as shown by the green line. The Model 26 cannot detect alpha or beta radiation while the filter is in place. Another option adds a headphone jack to the instrument body so headphones can be used to monitor the audio and the audio alarms. Headphones are also helpful when the instrument is being used in areas with high ambient noise levels or in areas where the audio might be distracting to others, such as a medical or office environment. Ludlum Measurements also offers the Model 180-28 sample holder that allows for repeatable geometry counting of wipes, filter paper, or slides. As always, we have more information on our website, or you can contact Ludlum's directly or your sales representative.